हाय चिल्ड्रन, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून। दिस इज एलके त्रिपाठी फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल गोला बाजार गोरखपुर। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। एज यू नो, द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज वेरी एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ आवर कंट्री। विदाउट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वी कैन नॉट होप टू रन द कंट्री प्रॉपरली एंड स्मूथली। कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज द सेट ऑफ रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन। Our constitution means the constitution of India is a written document. Nobody is above the law, and all the laws have been mentioned through the articles and through the schedules. In this chapter, we have studied about different types of articles and schedules. So further, we are going to discuss more about this. Why does a country need a constitution? Let's discuss. Today, most countries in the world have a constitution. In many parts of the country, there is the constitution. Without constitution, in democratic way, not possible to rule. While all democratic countries are likely to have a constitution, it is not necessary that all countries that have a constitution are democratic. No, it is not depend upon this point what we adopt in our country. Many countries are there, not necessary that the constitution is democratic there. The constitution serves several purposes. First, it lays out certain ideals that form the basis of the kind of country that we as citizens aspire to live in. Or put another way, a constitution tells us what the fundamental nature of our society is. A country is usually made up of different communities of people who share certain beliefs but may not necessarily agree on all issues. A constitution helps serve as a set of rules and principles that all persons in a country can agree upon as the basis of the way in which they want the country to be governed. This includes not only the type of government but also an agreement on certain ideals that they all believe the country should uphold. Let us try and understand what we mean by this through two contrasting situations in the recent history of Nepal, a country that borders India on the north. Until recently, Nepal was a monarchy. The previous constitution of Nepal, which had been adopted in 1990, reflects the fact that the final authority rested with the king. A people's movement in Nepal fought for several decades to establish democracy, and in 2006 they finally succeeded in putting an end to the powers of the king. The people had to write a new constitution
to establish Nepal as a democracy.
The reason that they did not want to continue with the previous constitution is because it did not reflect the ideals of the country that they want Nepal to be and that they have fought for. As in the game of football, in which a change in the constitutive rules will change the game altogether, Nepal, by moving from a monarchy to a democratic government, needs to change all its constitutive rules in order to answer in a new society. This is why the people of Nepal adopted a new constitution for the country in 2015. The caption alongside elaborates Nepal's struggle for democracy. The second important purpose of a constitution is to define the nature of a country's political system. For example, Nepal's earlier constitution stated that the country was to be ruled by the king and his council of ministers. In countries that have adopted a democratic form of government or polity, the constitution plays a crucial role in laying out certain important guidelines that govern decision making within these societies. In a democracy, we choose our leaders so that they can exercise power responsibly on our behalf. However, there is always the possibility that these leaders might misuse their authority, and the constitution usually provides safeguards against this. This misuse of authority can result in gross injustice, as demonstrated in the classroom situation below. What is the situation? See here through the example. Suresh is the class monitor. He is a bully, badmash. His classmates are not too fond of him. Classmates do not like him. Mrs. Roy, the class teacher, has to leave the classroom on some urgent work. She has to go out of the class. She asks Suresh to mind the class. As a monitor, she prefers responsibility to him. Suresh starts picking on Anil. Anil par Suresh picking karne lagta hai. Anil, today I am going to report you to Mrs. Roy. But what have I done? When Mrs. Roy returns to the class, ma'am, While you were away, Anil kept talking loudly and disturbing the class. He would not listen to me. This is the disobedience. So, क्या देखते हैं? In democratic societies, the constitution often lays down rules that guard against this misuse of authority by our political leaders. In the case of the Indian Constitution, above which you will read more later in this chapter, many of these laws are contained in the section of fundamental rights. Do you recall the chapter on the Dalit writer Om Prakash Valmiki's experience in school from your class 7th book? In that chapter, we talked about the discrimination Om Prakash faced because he was a Dalit. You read about how the Indian Constitution guarantees the rights to equality to all persons and says that no citizen can be discriminated against on grounds of religion, race, caste, gender, and place of birth. The right to equality is one of the fundamental rights guaranteed by the Indian Constitution. In this way, we have seen the glory of Indian Constitution. Again, I am going to repeat this line. Let us try and understand what we mean by this through two contrasting situations in the recent history of Nepal. Nepal ke bare mein jo hum situation dekhte hain nazdeek ke dinon mein, humko isko samajhne ki zarurat hai. A country that borders India on the north. North mein India ka border iska. Until recently, Nepal was a monarchy. कुछ समय पहले नेपाल एक मोनार्की था, वहाँ पर राजा का शासन था. एक ऐसा कंट्री जो राजतंत्र रहा अभी तक, बाद में जाकर के वहाँ डेमोक्रेसी आई. द प्रीवियस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ नेपाल विच हैड बीन अडॉप्टेड इन 1990 reflected the fact that the final authority rested with the king. जो previous constitution नेपाल का रहा 1990 में adopt किया गया, वो final authority राजा को ही घोषित करता है. The powers, ultimate powers will be rested in the hand of king. A people's movement in Nepal fought for several decades to establish democracy, and in 2006 they finally succeeded in putting an end to the powers of the king. For a long time, people's demand had been continued there. They demanded for democracy in Nepal. As a result, finally, it became democracy and it became democratic country. And in 2006, the power of king put down and a new constitution was established there. the people had to write a new constitution to establish Nepal as a democracy. The reason that they did not want to continue with the previous constitution is because it did not reflect the ideas of the country that they want Nepal to. लेकिन कारण ये था, वो जो प्रीवियस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन था वहाँ के लोग उसको कंटिन्यू नहीं रखना चाहते थे, क्योंकि जो आइडियल्स था कंट्री का नेपाल में फिर से वैसा ना रहे, ये बदल दिया जाए, इट शुड नॉट बी कंटिन्यू, एंड दैट दे हैव फॉट फॉर, जिसके लिए उन्होंने युद्ध किया था, लड़ाइयाँ लड़ी, वो चीज़ें नहीं रहनी चाहिए नेपाल. एज इन द गेम ऑफ फुटबॉल इन विच ए चेंज इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूटिव रूल्स विल चेंज द गेम ऑल टुगेदर. नेपाल बाय मूविंग फ्रॉम ए मोनार्की टू ए डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट नीड्स टू चेंज ऑल इट्स कॉन्स्टिट्यूटिव रूल्स इन ऑर्डर टू अशर इन ए न्यू सोसाइटी. This is why the Nepal, people of Nepal, adopted a new constitution for the country in 2015. The caption alongside elaborates Nepal's struggle for democracy. The second important purpose of a constitution is to define the nature of a country's political system. For example, Nepal's earlier constitution stated that the country was to be ruled by the king and his council of ministers. In countries that have adopted a democratic form of government or polity, the constitution plays a crucial role in laying out certain important guidelines that govern decision making within these societies. So, in a democracy, we choose our leaders so that they can exercise power responsibly on our behalf. However, there is always the possibility that these leaders might misuse their authority, and the constitution usually provides safeguards against this. This misuse of authority can result in gross injustice, as demonstrated in the classroom situation below. This discussion, we have discussed what the situation took place in the classroom here. In this way, we have finally saw that constitution is the set of rules and regulations on their behalf the country is governed. We shall discuss next in the next video. Thank you.